Welcome to the Center of Light Radio with spiritual teacher, intuitive, musician, composer, and best-selling author of The Divine Principle, Anchoring Heaven on Earth, your host, Keith Anthony Blanchard.
Power up and spread the light, y'all. It's almost Monday night. We're moving into the night. Yeah, big old full moon last night really dug. It was huge here in Memphis. I don't know if anyone had a chance to see it. Coast to coast, pole to pole, all around the world on the internet. Thanks to the marvel of technology, I am coming at you live from my little old guest house in Memphis, Tennessee. This is Keith Anthony Blanchard, and you are listening to Center of Light Radio, Center of Divine Unfoldment and Reinforcement, the superhighway to knowledge for that which is most important. And you know I'm talking directly to you because it's all about you. Power up, y'all, and we're going to have a good show tonight. Strapping all my brother and sister astronauts as we launch for inner space. It would mean a great deal to me if you, if you want to listen to any of the archive shows, you can go to YouTube and look up Center of Light Radio. There will be a playlist there, and you can tons of shows to choose from. They're all phenomenal broadcasts. You can bet on that. But while you're there, if there's a particular interview that you really enjoyed, give me a thumbs up. For sure, subscribe to my awesome channel because interviews are coming down the pike all the time. But so give me a comment in the comment box. That helps me to refine my guest search so I can bring forth the shows exactly that you're wanting. Maybe there's a particular field you'd like to know more about, something that feels good to your heart. Let me know what that is because I can do my research and find the guests that's out there that would lovingly happen and free bring that to you. All at the at your computer or on your phone, depending on how you are listening. A couple of services I want to announce. Also, make sure you go to Center of Light Radio and look to the right-hand side of the opening page. There you will see a subscription form. Fill it out to get my monthly newsletter. I put a lot of time and a lot of hours into this newsletter program. I will not send you junk. You have my word on that. But also, signing up for that newsletter will give you access to my lifelong work, R.P.M., Recognize, Plug In, and Manifest Your Life. Powerful program it is. It's a once-a-month installment. You get videos, you get workbooks, and all this kind of stuff, and it's for a year. The program lasts for 1 year, and it's not about fixing you because you're broken. It's about helping you to expand further into your bliss. RPM, Recognize, Plug In, and Manifest Your Life. Some services that I provide, I've been speaking for many, many years, life-changing presentations on spirituality, divine avatars, divine incarnations, extraterrestrials. I have also helped people fulfill their dreams of living their passion. I do spiritual readings, life coaching. I don't go at it from a psychic point of view. No one is more psychic about your life than you. But sometimes we can use a fresh perspective, a different pair of eyes and ears, if you will, to help us. Sometimes we get a little too close to our own life and we can't see. And I would love to help you get clear so you can make the choices that you may not have seen. So that clearing process will help you to be able to gauge the choices that you can make that will help you beat your feet towards your bliss. Also, if you have spiritual squatters in your house, ghost spiritual squatter, and they're not paying rent and you want them out and they're causing you nothing but trouble. I know what it's like. I've helped many people remove lower level entities from their house, and I will bring with me, if you're in the Memphis area, or if we do this online, I will still bring with me and offer to you an arsenal of information that will help raise your vibration, and poof, they will disappear just as quickly as they came in. You can bet on that. Swamiji Viswayogi, God-realized man from India. Still no word of when he's coming. Hopefully that will be soon. And while you're at Center of Light Radio, click the tab, Do What You Love course, Do What You Love Forever. You get a big old bag of goodies, my bestseller, self-reflection workbook, Divine Daily Supplements, the movie about my life. If you have not seen it yet, it's a phenomenal, empowering movie. It lasts an hour and a half. Made by Blue Cast Productions out of New York. It's the story of my life, how I am able to do what I do as a full-time musician and author. I promise you there's lots of information there that will supply you with what you need to get on your way, again, towards doing those things that you really get a kick out of. You also get the multimedia music album of The Divine Principle. And finally, you get the Anchoring Heaven on Earth audio meditation. $5. This is the last week I am running that special. And one more announcement before we get down to what we're all about here at Center of Light Radio. If you go to Center of Light Radio, look at the top banner. You will see that I am about to start the Celestial Bar. It's a place for socializing and watching a movie once a week. And that's going to occur Tuesday nights from 5 to 7 p.m. Of course, that's Central Time. You're going to have to fill out a form, sign up, It's not really a big deal. But I'm going to be airing a movie once a week. We can have discussion. You know, you can have a drink, bring you wine, bring whatever it is you do feel like you would bring with yourself if you go into a social atmosphere, into a club or bar kind of setting is the kind of groove I'm trying to create there. So all that being said, now it's time to get down to Center of Light Radio business. Today, my guest was Mr. Robert Novak, and we will be discussing Fulfill Your Destiny, the Spirituality of Success. Well, it sounds like what I just described about beating your feet towards your bliss. If you want to call into the show today, the number you dial is 888-919-2355, 888-919-2355. Let me tell you about my guest today. Mr. Robert Novak is a master, intuitive, inspiring teacher, writer, speaker, personal consultant, and Yuen Method master. Robert's divinely inspired transformational work with clients is the catalyst, providing them the empowerment and improvements in their life to become their own self-expert, to know their purposes in life, and to live them. Robert has the unique ability to pinpoint exactly the answer to improve and progress one's life. Robert is the creator of the Advancing Life Network, where he shares inspiring writings, meditations, and videos to advance one's life. You can find more of my phenomenal guest tonight at bewillingtobeamazed.com. Welcome to Center of Light Radio, Robert Novak.
Thank you so much, Keith. It's a pleasure being here.
Your bio sounds like everything I said up to the introduction of bringing you on the show, sir. We have a lot in common.
I love it. Absolutely. That's why I'm so excited to be here with you.
This is going to make for a great dance and dynamic. You can bet. Robert, tell me a little more about what you do. How did you get into this? Did you, like many of us, come from something not really cool happening in life and you were put on your knees and humbly you supplicated to the universe, you know, I need some help? Or is this something that you moved in and from a different space entirely?
Well, I'll share two experiences. I mean, right after college, I used to pray, Jesus, teach me so I may teach, right? And of course, you're led to many different things from that aspect. And you just kind of walk sometimes where it doesn't make any sense where you walk, right? And that kind of started the journey, you know, many years ago. But 9 years ago, my wife passed of cancer. And that really started me on diving into my whole aspect of what I was being called to do, you know, even deeper. Went through many different, learning many different healing modalities, but really dropping into a bigger divine purpose and started writing and all kinds of other things.
Yeah.
Right?
I get it. Sort of the same with me, different scenario, but there's a lot of parallels there. Looking here at your notes, let's talk a little bit about the creating universe and the universe's potential.
Right, exactly. And what I like to do is when we start sharing, you know, about how to fulfill one's destiny, I like to really, you know, get down to some basics, say, you know what, this is a creating universe. And I think a lot of times we think that it's kind of static, but it's in constant motion. And when you look at this universe, it's a universe of potentials, okay? And the fundamental building block of this universe is potential. And everything in this universe is made up of the same basic primary particles, which is an energy potential. And I think, you know, this is one of the things that we don't connect with as much. And that's why I want to, you know, help people understand this or connect with it. Because if we start looking at what that really means, I mean, let's look at even what quantum research says. I mean, quantum research says that the basic primary particles or this energy, it behaves in different ways depending on what the observer is expecting to see. So, of course, they theorize that it must be intelligent. And in my opinion, everything in this universe has an innate awareness, okay, that we're connected with. Everything is aware. And I think this is really, really important for everyone to connect with, because it's so, so, so true. So when we look at, an oxygen atom, I mean, this oxygen atom, can break down between neutrons, protons, electrons, and what makes up, every bit of that is this basic primary particle, like everything, right? I mean, so the chair we're sitting on, our body, I mean, one of the things that I think, people don't connect with sometimes is just our body, our skin, our organs, they're in constant motion, right? because everything is in constant motion. It's this energy potential, for whatever reason, staying together or aware of the functions it needs to be carrying out. And I think this is really important for us to connect with, because this is when we can start looking at how we can change those potentials, because the potentials of the universe are in constant state of flex responding to us, okay? Our programming, our desires, our affirmations, our prayers, our thoughts, and our emotions. I mean, we are the instruments of creation that affect everything in this universe. And I know sometimes people ask me, it's like, well, what about God, Source? And, as far as I'm concerned, Source works through us, like every living thing in this universe.
You had mentioned a moment ago awareness. I'm really big on awareness. You also said that everything has an awareness. Now, that being said, that seems to me it implies that if everything has an awareness, everything is alive. And if everything is alive, and as spiritualists, we are of the belief, many of us, some may not, that everything ever created is already created. If that is the case, the word that everything has potential to be created, is it more of the idea that everything has been created and there's a potential for us through awareness to tap into that experience, to bring it into experience? Or do you think everything is just a potential sea of energy?
Well, definitely different perspectives here, but I think a potential sea of energy that is consistently changing and molding based on how we respond also to what the Source wants us to hopefully respond to as well. But it's changing in that whole, creative aspect of everything that's happening.
Yeah, yeah. I'm looking at further down the list of notes, and I'm seeing that you have purpose. Let's talk a little bit about purpose, because a lot of people happen to come across this show for the first time, and I think a lot of people don't have a really clear understanding of what purpose is. They think purpose is, oh gosh, some etheric idea, and I need to live my purpose and doing things on purpose. But I think purpose is much deeper than that. How does one go about finding that purpose in their life, Robert?
Well, what I like to, first say on that is how one finds their purposes. First of all, let's, make sure that everyone understands that a fundamental principle of human existence is action to be in motion, right? So it doesn't mean that our action is necessary on purpose. The key is taking this inspired action. So there's a connection that we're making with, the divine within us, the light within us, the universe, the responses that, we're getting from the universe, to connect and follow and kind of wonder, be curious, like, why am I being led here? What's going on? So that's that inspired action. And then I think from there, as we're being that active participant, things start to unfold, right? So what I always like to refer to also is something that an ascended master shared with us. And he said that the all-encompassing purpose of life is finding God in yourself, your talents, and your sacred labor, and endowing anything you can do with God's spirit. And to me, this means living your beingness, your unique expression of the divine, right? And sharing you as unique expression with everybody. And you start finding that by, one, connecting with yourself. Right. And then when you start actually showing up and starting to share yourself with others, you start discovering a little bit more about yourself. And without, judging and everything else, what's going on with yourself, you just keep connecting with all those different experiences to see, how things are coming about. Now, you can also, use a lot of God's divine creations to find out some other aspects of your purpose. you know, in which I have a little ebook on my website that shares with that. But that's really the main thing, because it's unfolding consistently with you. This, you know, as you take this inspired action, the purpose and everything that you're doing is very purposeful, because it affects everyone in this universe, whatever you're doing.
I really like that you said that the only purpose is exploring, finding, seeking God. And if God is love, when you do what you love, then you are living the essence of your being. And that puts you in a different category altogether, because, you know, the people that I work with, I share with them and help empower them to the idea that when, you know, you begin to do what you love, you put your heart into it, and therefore you become better at it than anyone else because of your own unique expression about it all. And so your worth goes up, because I remember many, many years ago wanting to be a professional musician. I would go to these paint sites when I was doing a job as a painter, and I really didn't care about the work. My lines were terrible because I had no heart in it. And so because my lines were terrible, I would not get a raise. And so the downfall of that job began. But when I started walking the walk as a professional musician and also as a spiritual teacher and also writing books as an author and so forth and so on, I began to put my heart into it, and it, making that connection of my heart to God, my heart, and it reinforced that connection. And all of a sudden, you really become alive. You don't just exist, you become alive. And in so doing, by spiritual law, really without all the effort of the job you might have had before, because now you're living your purpose, your connection to divine, and expressing your essence, by natural law, abundance becomes the product of being happy.
Absolutely. I mean, well put. There's no question. I mean, if I, again, connect with myself, it's like I want to share as much as I can with different wisdoms that's coming through me, right? And write it, share it, speak it. And that is just brings so much joy, that passion, right? So absolutely agreed.
I had a discussion the other night with a friend of mine, and we were talking about God, higher purpose, whatever person chooses to call the source of all creation. And we were playing this game, and I was asking him to point to himself. And he pointed to the center of his chest. Mm-hmm. Then I asked him to point to God. Now, keep in mind, I'm from the Bible Belt. No judgment, just a fact of the matter. And when he was actually in motion to point to his chest the second time to identify where God lived, halfway through the motion, he stopped, and the look on his face, something inside of him said, you know, this is cognitive dissonance. We're not going to go there just yet. But I've never seen anyone, when I asked them to point to themselves, point to their side of their temple, to the mind. A lot of people believe that the mind is located in the brain. That is not true whatsoever. The mind is in every available space within the body. The body is really in the mind, or said a different way, the body is the mind manifested. Yes?
I like to look at the body is this, has this physical intelligence, okay, which is all connected with this innate awareness of everything that comes together that's physical, right? Look at the mind, actually not the brain, and the brain not the mind, but there is this essence of this intelligence of everything coming together that makes up this, if you want to say, body brain, okay? And you know, so when I look at and do the work that I do, I'm actually separating out the mind from the body. So then the mind does not create a lot of problems, because it's kind of a non-physical type of thing, but it is here for us to use. Okay, so by separating it out, we're able then to be, if you want to say, more calmer, because the physical intelligence, this body that we've been given, that's so incredible, is now operating, you know, a little bit, you know, better. And it's kind of like even the Buddha recognized no mind is the best place to be, but it's not by meditating it. It's by kind of just separating it out so it can actually be used as servant and not master. I'm not sure if that answers your question, but that's how I look at the mind.
Very nice. Very nice. The title of this interview is fulfill your destiny, the spirituality of success. And though one of the first components, probably the most important, the umbrella of which shelters everything else, would be, you know, finding your purpose, connecting with source, and also having that revealed to you, which is your heart, your passion, yet your power. Your essence of who you are, and living that essence brings light into the world and creates equilibrium in the home, because one doesn't come home grumpy from work and take it out on the wife and the children and so forth and so on. But are there other nuts and bolts that you can offer here today for our listening audience about helping them fulfill their destiny and having that spiritual success?
Right, absolutely. And I love to talk a little bit, you know, about our body, since we kind of brought it up, so we can start, you know, making that distinction of what incredible, you know, say, vessel we've been given. Because here, if we start breaking down our body and start looking at how incredible it is, I mean, every cell, you know, in our body has these cell receptors that are processing millions of bits of information every second, right? And in every cell is a power plant, you know, the mitochondria.
That's pretty serious awareness to be processing millions of bits of information.
Exactly, right? So there's something really powerful about this. But here's what's really amazing, Keith, is if we, you know, looked at the nucleus of every living cell, it contains DNA, which science says is the raw information or instructions that make us who and what we are. Okay, this is what science is saying. But what's fascinating is if you took the DNA out of one cell and stretched it, it would be 6 feet long. Okay, now if you took the DNA out of every cell in one person's body, just one person's body, and stretched it, it would go back and forth to the sun 150 times.
Jeez.
Exactly, right? But here's even more fascination. If we took all the, you know, people's DNA on the planet, however many, 7 billion people, and scrunched it together, it would fit in the space as small as a grain of rice. Okay, so what that says is we live in an engineered masterpiece, a very sophisticated vessel, right? That is definitely a temple that is continually evolving. So in this, you know, body, I like to always say it's a perceiving, recording, and creating biocomputer, and that every cell in this body is intelligent, and it works best when every cell is communicating, supporting, responding, and creating, and in sync with each other. This is when the body acts in more wholeness, and that's why we separate out the mind, so then this body that we've been given, that we are in, is able to function better.
888-919-2355, 888-919-2355 is the number you dial to speak to me or my phenomenal guest today, Mr. Robert Novak. Robert, tell me some more about the body and how we can use this towards walking our feet down towards our purpose. I mean, we talked about the brain, we're talking about the body. How do we begin to integrate some of the more esoteric aspects of this to make this a whole usable system?
Right, exactly. So let's look at, you know, first a couple of things that we can use this body, this physical intelligence, to help us identify some things that aren't working, you know, necessarily the way we want them to work as far as the symptoms of our body or symptoms of our life, let's say with relationship, finances, whatever else. So to do that, I'm going to give you a little bit of example of something, you know, I did when I was at an expo. I was at an expo and saying I was going to delete stress and pain on the spot. And so this lady came up to me and said, well, I'd like for you to attempt to do that. And she was a yoga instructor, Ayurvedic, you know, practitioner, but she had this pain, you know, in her right shoulder, and it was on the scale, a scale of 1 to 10, it was a 6. So from there, what I did was I felt her right shoulder, not physically, just, you know, energetically. You know, I said, okay, right shoulder. And the right shoulder was strong, meaning that there was no problem with that right shoulder. Immediately though, in connecting with her, again, just energetically, her biocomputer, her body's sending me to her left shoulder because that was the weaker part. So I'm following this weakest, weakness. And I strengthened her left shoulder energetically, and then her breastbone, and then reproductive area. I just led that quickly. And then I asked her, I said, what's the level of pain now? She said, it's a 4. So it changed a little bit. Then from there, I said, okay, tell me what is weaker to you between these two things, physical or non-physical? And she said, non-physical. Now, non-physical breaks down between spiritual and mental. So I said, okay, what is weaker, spiritual or mental? She said, spiritual. As soon as she said that, then I got the insight that, you know, what happened was a spiritual experience of her ancestors where they used to, or they had, stab someone in the shoulder. Okay, so I went ahead and just resolved that very quickly. Okay, and then I asked her, I said, what is the level of pain now? She goes, it's gone. So here's the thing. I mean, the mind and logic and our medical practitioners and everyone else, and even what way we connect with it, is it's like, hey, the pain's in the right shoulder. So logically, it's saying the problem's the right shoulder, but it wasn't. Okay, in this case, and this is why I say the body likes to work on wholeness, it was other parts of the body not, you know, supporting energetically another part of the body. So by using this innate intelligence, innate awareness of the body, of the universe, and following the weakness, it gave us the signals of what needed to be strengthened so then it can support what's going on. But also, it gave us the information that was needed to help resolve a pain. Now, again, this could be with anything systematic in our life. So relationships, finances, and everything else, your body will lead you to what that is by, you know, following this energetic weakness for you to strengthen, and if you want to say delete the accumulated effects, so then you can be more empowered to be able to have a better relationship, have better finances, better career, whatever it is that systematically is causing a problem, even a physical pain, which is fascinating, right? Right? So here, I do the Yuen method, and this method of transformation calls it spiritual experiences, which again could be spiritual experiences of you, your ancestor, your descendants, could be the collective, the culture, your family, or even religion influences over time and space causing the pain or the symptom. Now, also, I was able to see the Body Code 2.0 demonstrated this past year, Dr. Bradley Nelson, and they demonstrated what they called inherited emotions, which is a lot of what I'm talking about as far as from this ancestor. They have documented proof where people avoided surgeries by eliminating an emotion that was not even the person's emotion. It was inherited from the ancestors. So in this case, you know, one of the cases, it was shown that, okay, this emotion, is it coming from mom or dad? Oh, well, it's coming from dad. Okay, is it coming from dad's dad or dad's mom? And then they counted back how many generations. And Keith, you know how they solved the problem then? After identifying how many generations it went back, they simply ran a magnet down the person's spinal cord, and it was relieved. Okay, so our body gives us indications of what needs to happen by following the weaknesses. It's very fascinating. And this is what we do with the Yuen method, but we're just energetically working with the spinal cord, you know, over the phone. It doesn't matter. You can be anywhere to be able to do the work, right? And this is how we assist people in changing their symptoms or pains in their life.
When you mentioned that you worked on this woman's shoulder, did she connect with the idea, and did you share with her about her past ancestors, about the stabbing in the shoulder? In other words, was she aware that this took place?
Now, I told her, I said when I connected with it, that it was, this was the case, and then I went ahead and just, you know, deleted it. That was the only thing. She did not have an awareness that was the concern.
But you did share her what you received on that level. And so my point of asking this question is, did you do energy work? Yes, you did. Or did the energy work also come in the form of her awareness of such a situation? And I asked that because last week, I believe it was, I had Mr. David Matthew Brown on Center of Light Radio, and he and I were playing with the subject of awareness back and forth, and it was really, really juicy and delicious conversation. And so we often talk about in the light of awareness. And if awareness is light, and someone's issue could represent dark or density, a problem, he was sharing with the listening audience and myself, excuse me, that he was a counselor at a summer camp, and there was a bully, and David was selected to work with the bully. So he walked up to the bully and said, you know, the only thing, words that he mentioned to the bully says, "Hi, I'm Counselor David. Are you aware of yourself?" He didn't try to fix the kid. He didn't try to do anything to the kid. And the next day he returned and said, "Counselor David here." He says, "Are you aware of yourself?" And this happened 3 or 4 days in a row. On the fourth day, the little kid said, "I know you're about to ask me if I'm aware of myself." And he says, "Are you aware of yourself?" And it was about a 15-second pause. And then the kid split open right in half and began to lament and began to talk to David in a very real way about some things that were truly, truly bothering him from his home setting.
Right, exactly. So in this case with Judy or anyone, do they have to hear what it is for it to be resolved? They do not. Okay. I've done many times and have, you know, seen Dr. Yuen, you know, address it also with just total silence and even in another language, right? So we can connect with, you know, a person's weakness of their body because there is no communication problem, right? And you don't have to say it for them to get it. I like to explain it just so they have the awareness, but don't have to.
Tell me a little more, if you would please, about Dr. Yuen.
Oh, he's, very fascinating. He right now he's 75 years old, but he was, do you remember the TV show Kung Fu at David Carradine?
I do.
Yeah, well, Dr. Yuen was a technical advisor, but also one of David Carradine's teachers. So he's a Shaolin Grandmaster of Kung Fu.
Is this the guy some years ago when VHS was kicking that he did the Tai Chi? Is that the guy?
It's possible. I'm not aware if that was him, but it is very possible. But he's an actual aerospace engineer, a doctor of chiropractic. So he's used his, you know, talents to be able to bring forward a whole method of understanding and resolving, you know, people's pains. He just did a thing with the NFL football players, like retirees that have been pain for like 20, 30 years, and totally resolved the pain on the spot for them. And that's a video. You can go out at YouTube and see it. It's fascinating. It's beautiful.
That's the guy, Cam Ewing.
Yes.
I just looked it up. Yeah. In fact, I bought the Tai Chi video and did it for quite a while. And I really enjoyed it. And I felt a lot of changes happening in my energy. A lot of changes happened in my body. But yeah, I remember seeing this this grandmaster doing this Tai Chi. And it was very, very beautiful to watch. It was very, very cool.
And I recommend everyone to get, you know, his book that's out, Delete Stress and Pain on the Spot, and then get some training. That's one of the things I do. I'm a certified instructor and, you know, we'll work with it. It's great work.
Robert, we're at the bottom of the hour. Would you give out your contact information so our listening audience can find out more about you and the awesome things and powerful things that you're doing in this world, right?
Absolutely. The website is bewillingtobeamazed.com. And of course, I developed that because I'm always amazed at what transpires in different sessions. And that's what I love about doing the work. I do want to share that I have live demonstrations of my work the first and third Tuesdays of every month at 7:30 Central. So just go out on my website and sign up for that, because this is where we get to actually take in callers and resolve things within minutes for them. It's beautiful. But bewillingtobeamazed.com.
I love the title of that. That's really right. And you have to come from a very clear space to boast such a URL. Otherwise, it would come across. A lot of my work, Robert, involves helping people move through their crap, moving through the blocks. And I always tell them, you can't go over it. You can't go around it. You can only go through it. And when a person steps into that funky, strange place, yeah, it feels just that way. It feels funky and strange. But if they stay in there and they hold themselves in there and they become present in there, that in and of its, again, awareness, light, becoming aware of something that's happening with you in and of itself is a lot or enough to change it. What is some of your techniques to help move people through their barriers that may be blocking them from a greater level of spirituality, greater level of bliss or clarity?
Well, I would just want to share exactly what you're saying. Holding that space is very important. Okay, so it's definitely one thing that I do. And so that it helps them to hold the space of their own light to transfer, you know, transition through that. I think that's very, very, very important, right? The other things, of course, is the Yuen method itself, as far as strengthening the central nervous system, because that's the key. Everything happens in our body through our central nervous system. So if we're energetically stronger, then we're able to transition through things simpler, right? And then it's just following the weaknesses, okay? And when I say weaknesses, your body will give that indication. But no matter what, doing what you said to do, to go into it, is good. One of the things with the Yuen method is we talk about false tools and how we haven't really been trained on how to deal with things. So we use these false tools like suppression, denying, lying, numbing, forgetting, right? Shutting down. We use these things versus going right into it. And it's so important to go right into it, right? And bring that light and love. And if you can't do it on your own, that's when you get the assistance of someone else, because when two of us come together and hold that space for each other and that purity and no judgment, gosh, brother, things just beautifully happen. And that's where the amazing thing happens, right?
I felt your charge just now about you saying what you were saying.
Yeah, right? I mean, it's so much of, you know, what I do. It's not just the Yuen method. It's just a holding that space. And it's so, so, so real. And it's so amazing. And that's, I absolutely love it. Absolutely love it.
I want to talk a bit for about potential blocks. Many years in my life, Robert, the technique I use, I don't know if this is supported by the Yuen method or if it's even one of their methods and I'm just not aware of it, or even something you support personally, is when something potential for many years that was going to happen, that happened in my life, that could have energetically buried its claws in me and stuck around for a long time because I had the awareness about myself, enough awareness about spirituality to know that when something devastating or something very, very powerful that could have kicked my ass for many years if I didn't do something about it as soon as possible. When it goes down, when it's happening, I begin to find myself present with it. I don't try to suppress it. I don't try to shove it down. I don't try to go, I don't go in denial. All those things you just named, those false tools. In fact, I let it be there. And what I do is I begin breathing like a madman. And so what I'm doing is I'm disassembling it before it can ever become energetically a part of who I am. And this has worked very, very effective for me in many, many situations in my life. Is there something you can share to support or denounce such a claim that it works for me? Is there something you've heard of?
Oh, I think what you're describing is right on, right? You're adding breath and that energy to helping that move, and you're putting that awareness to it, which is very important, right? And it can be painful. Even with the way you were explaining it, it felt a little pain there. And that is that movement that has to happen, right? That energy has to break apart, dissipate. So therefore, there's no charge there anymore. So when doing that, the best you can do is to bring in that light, your own light to the situation is perfect. So, you know, we should be connecting with our own light at least daily, if not a few times during the day, to get that recharge. And that can just take a few moments. So when those things happen, the light that's in us can actually help us through those times, because it happens. You know, even me, you know, that still happens. Okay. It's knowing the what to do with it. And that's the key. And what you described is perfect.
You know, if God is breath, Yes. God yes. breathed life into man, and God happens through breath. It makes sense to me in such situations. We bring God into it by breathing. I had a friend of mine some years ago I interviewed. It was the first time I ever heard such a thing, and it was strangely beautiful. She said, if you want to find God, don't follow the light within you. Follow the dark. And it took me a minute, and when I got it, it made sense to me. What she was saying is, you know, to reach greater degrees of light, we have to move through those things that are blocking the light. And so I understood her point that the path to God is in the darkness.
Yes, and it's so great. No, I love that you bring this up. I love it because in my advancing life through God's inspiration oracle deck, I have a shadow card. And in that description, I say the shadow will lead you to your light. Okay, so God works in both the dark and the light. So yes, go into that shadow, go into that dark so that it can lead you to something greater, that light, God. What it is that you, another piece to see, right? So it's perfect. I love it.
888-919-2355, 888-919-2355 is the number you call to talk to me on the show and my awesome guest today, Mr. Robert Novak. Robert, one thing I'd like to share with you now and also open up a can of discussion is about controlling and allowing. I've mentioned to a lot of people that I work with, a lot of my videos, if we can liken the wheel of control to this wheel that spins in our, let's say, the middle of our chest in one direction, say forward to back. And the more we control, the faster that wheel begins to move. And now someone is open to the idea of relinquishing control and moving to the space of allowing. And the more one is able to do that, that wheel that was spinning from front to back, up to down, begins to slow down. Now, when they get so proficient at it and the wheel stops, quote, there is no movement. And that place can be a little funky because one can feel like they're falling. But stay there. Stay in the allowing phase. Then the wheel begins to spin in the opposite direction. And the more you found yourself releasing control and letting go and allowing, the faster the wheel is going to spin for you in a way that you are with the current and not against. And then your life begins to take on the attributes of effortlessness and easiness. Would you say so, sir?
I agree. And I think what you're, you know, describing is presence in a lot of, you know, degrees is when we can actually allow and be in that space like you're describing, then we really start developing this presence, right? And one of the things that when people, I think, hear allowing, that somehow they think is kind of like being a victim, and I wanted to share that this is not, you know, like being a victim or a sign of weakness, but really a sign of strength and awareness, because in that allowing, you're allowing your full presence and allowing experiences to enhance or change you, or in the same time, you're giving space for the other people in there to be also in that space of allowing. Right? Where then more presence and God-like energy is being shared, more love, right? Because that openness versus trying to control and have an agenda of what may happen in it, right? So I love the way you described it, for sure.
And that would be showing up, right?
Exactly.
Showing up, being present with the situation.
Exactly.
Bad situation, good situation, just being present. Phenomenal.
Right.
Let's talk a little bit about the tool of I am here. Even though that sounds like it's another spin on the word of showing up or being present, I feel that you put it in these notes for a particular reason other than what we just discussed.
I did. And so what I like to do is just connect, right? If you start pulling in, let's say we take our hands like in a prayer space, and we just start pulling in that energy and saying, I am here. Or you can say, here I am, right? It starts bringing everything in. And that awareness to that, you know, center point to where this is where we're then able to share ourselves better and also be receivers of what is present for us and for everybody.
my mind immediately went to school children and teachers giving roll call. And she says, John Doe, here, I'm here, or present.
Right.
See, they're learning this stuff at a very fundamental level.
Absolutely.
I've heard children, and it's very interchangeably, I've heard them say, here or present.
Yeah, exactly.
I wonder if they, any of the teachers has any, have any idea of the seed, that's the foundation that's being laid there for now. Let's talk a little bit about the laws of attraction in the universe. You know, I understand the law of attraction, the movie, and the idea. And Robert, I support a lot of it, but I think there's a lot of components missing out of the formula that can really guarantee people success by using said formula.
Right. And I like to, you know, first just break it down to the simplicity of what we've already been talking about I am here and showing up. And having everyone understand that the law of attraction is not something out there in the universe, or any law is not out there in, if you want to say, in the universe. You're right in the center of all laws, right in the center. So, right? So, you know, without knowing or putting definition of what all those are, let's first get ourselves in that I am here, that presence, and to where then it can actually start operating, right? Because how can we fully want to, if you want to say, assist with the outcome in this creating universe if we're not fully present in that aspect of what we're trying to, if you want to say, attract or manifest or just to be, right? It's really getting down to being. But anyways, that's my first initial thing that I want to share. It's like, let's first be fully present from that space.
Yes, yes, yes. Because in the beingness of it all is where everything will well spring from, and it's through you. See, and that's one of the issues I have with that whole. And I get it. It was a great revolution that started, and yes, it helped people go from where they were to another place. But now we can refine that process. So it did have a very phenomenal, profound purpose. So, right, it's not the law of attraction of anything. You're not attracting anything,
right,
really.
Right.
It's about right, becoming it. And we see it's really not about becoming it, because we're it already. It's yes, about allowing it to show up in your field of vision.
Yes. Beautiful. Yes. And then just, you know, really being with everything. And that's when you start taking that inspired action. And everything else, right? You're just really present to everything that's happening, the awareness. And also, there's a component of you using your own awareness intelligence to bring something forward. So that is also that component. But isn't it a lot better when we're actually more present in that space of awareness versus the place of the mind or fear or anything else and trying to force it from that place?
Yeah, everything in our field, everything is in our field. In every cell, yes, in every proton, it's all. In fact, it's the very stuff that make up what and who. Well, I wouldn't say who, but what we are and what we identify with on a daily basis. So, getting to use a word, those things we like to happen in our life is really not about using some magic wand or some home hocus pocus idea notion that you are believing in because of a movie. That's just really never going to cut it. It's about, you know, being present and seeing that you are it itself, and mm-hmm, therefore by natural law, again, doing what you love. And when you love yourself, obviously you're present with self, and then light. In fact, you don't even at that point in level of mastery, you don't even have to ask the universe for things anymore. It's not about the asking in the formal way of saying, you know, I want to call this to me. You actually, we get out of the game of wanting stuff or things or events to happen in our life, because we're now smart enough at that place or intellectual enough to know it's just a matter of getting out the way, and beyond anything we can ever have envisioned for ourselves begins to happen in greater ways we could have ever envisioned for ourselves.
Beautiful. Well put.
Robert, we are slowly getting towards the top of the hour, and I would really like to get to this topic, and we have a few minutes for sure, about sharing you. It is important to all of us.
Absolutely. When we can actually recognize that we are this unique expression of the divine, right? And we start sharing ourselves from that place. That's why we want to get us present to I am here, right? And sharing from that place, you know, there's a great grand design in everything. So we all came here with a certain, you know, unique expression to share in this world. So when we can actually start doing that, then it starts affecting all of us in the way it was designed to affect. So I, you know, we want to express to everyone, share you, and from there you will learn more about yourself and continue to bring on a whole other realm of fulfillment, because you're doing that. You're being you and doing you, and that's important to all of us, all life.
Yeah, I'm just taking it all.
Yeah, right?
Yeah, you know, being the spiritual teacher or whatever it is that I claim I am for ratings and whatever else to impress people, you know, it's more often than not that I sit in this chair like anyone else and have been and are wowed by my guests. And I'm really loving the dialogue. But we sadly, and again, I have not sent that email, shame on me, without punishment. I'm not going to judge myself. Shame on me, but I don't want to disappoint my listening audience. Don Danny has been asking me, and maybe he is the universe trying to give me a message about expanding Center of Light Radio to a 2-hour show. Because once we get down, it really into the meat and potatoes of it all, we're at the top of the hour and my guest signs off, and sadly, it just goes away. To another week. So I'm still working on that. And you can bet I'm going to have a response from my producers, Joe, Bob, and MJ this week. I'm going to send that out tomorrow. Would you leave us with a final thought, my friend, something that our listening audience can take with them and begin to implement that in their daily life? And so they can see some of the changes that happen, not in the world, but within themselves. And by cause and effect, they will see their outer realities change.
Well, I want to share this aspect or this insight also, that God is an outlaw path. And what I mean by that, right? What I mean by that is that you are your own unique expression of the divine, and you cannot fulfill being you following the path of another, their methods, Amen. Beliefs, or rules. So this is where you're an outlaw against those things. So that means you're an outlaw with God, not against God. And I think it's really important, because I'm all about God. I'm all about the light. And I would love for everyone to be that expression in the world. And to do that, you know, I have a free meditation on my website called Sit With God. And it's just that intention of connecting and sit with God. Don't have to meditate. Don't have to pray. Just the intention of sitting with God. You will, you know, learn more about your expression, and you'll get the inspirations to be that outlaw with God and, you know, against everyone else's definitions.
I really love that. Outlaw with God.
Yes.
Spiritual rebellion. Spiritual rebel. What's coming down the pike for you, sir? What do you get your hands into?
Well, I do a number of different things, which, of course, I got another book coming out, Living the God Formula, Fulfill Your Destiny. And that's actually going to be made into a program this next year, to where we can assist people going through this process, really opening them up. That's one of my gifts, of just in that space, be able to open people up in that without having to do anything, right? So that's really beautiful. And then also I'll be teaching the Yuen Method starting in January, which again is a method that I absolutely love, or I wouldn't be an instructor of it. I also do what's called Improve the Potentials of Your Life Gathering, which I do those quarterly. And this is where, for that quarter, I am working, you know, on removing the weaknesses, if you want to say, and strengthening your potential, you know, in this physical essence of you, but also mind and spirit. And it's incredible the responses that we've gotten so far of how people's lives have changed because of it. Because we're, you know, if you want to say strengthening them, for the best, you know, words I can use, or integrating them back in and get rid of the symptoms that's been holding them back. Let's put it that way. And for a quarter of doing this, it's tremendous. It's we absolutely love doing it, and people love the experience. So I love doing that for people as well.
Robert, thank you for being a fantastic guest here on Center of Light Radio, sir.
You're very welcome. I'm so glad we connected, and I very much appreciate that of all your wisdom and your love for everybody.
You can bet on that, sir. And that door swings open to you. You're welcome back. Keep us posted on what you're doing. We'd like to get you back on Center of Light Radio. Thank you.
That's great. Thank you, Keith.
Wow, wow, wow. Like I said just a minute ago, I'm always wowed as a guest, as these guests come on Center of Light Radio and pour out their heart, pour out everything they're about, being present. It does a number on me, and I learn something every time, something valuable. And a lot of it doesn't really hit me till later in the week. And a lot of shows begin to crossfade, to begin amalgamate, to begin to marry. And then I begin to see something beyond understanding, beyond logic, rather, that takes place as a new thread. And they start binding and connecting to each other in ways that are beyond logic. And somehow there's an inkling, and like some things Robert said, some things that David Matthew Brown said. There's a higher language always speaking, and I begin to see that unfolding in my life or unfolding within myself. Next week on Center of Light Radio, I cannot sit still for this show. If you know me, you know what I'm about, the things that really get me going. All spirituality gets me going. But a subject, for example, like time travel, I prayed to God, I prayed to inner self. For a while, I was looking, and then I stopped looking. I showed my intention, and then I stopped looking. And this guy by the name of Bob Mitchell showed up. He wrote a book in partnership with Jason Quitt. Bob recently passed away, so we're going to send that show out next week to Bob Mitchell. But Jason was the one informing me about that Bob had passed away, and he was taking care of all of Bob's affairs. Well, while I got him, Jason was the actual time traveler. I said, well, would you like to be interviewed in his stead? He said, absolutely. I'd love to do the show. So Jason Quitt is going to be next here, and we're going to be speaking about forbidden knowledge, tales of a time traveler. I'm going to be in my best game for that, you can bet. I do appreciate you here, Center of Light Radio, every Monday night, 6 p.m. Eastern Time. I am your host. Remember, let's be present. Let's be aware. Fall into yourself by breathing, meditation. It'll get you through the ceiling of thought. And next thing you know, you'll find yourself in that profound, deafening silence. And you will be able to hear the voice of God, which is really you. And you'll be able to hear yourself talk. And that voice in your head will no longer be the voice in your head. It will be the voice in your heart. God bless you. I'll see you soon. Peace, love, and light. Ease into bliss.